Welcome to Analytics with Nux. In this video, I'm going to talk about a line chart in the Visuals with Nux series. Let's begin our today's topic. When to use a line chart? So this is used to track changes over short and long period of time. Basically, you want to compare a measure against your date or time, then you can go for a line graph. And line graph can also be used to compare changes over same period of time for more than one group. And typically, like, you have a line graph and you want to compare the measure against a group of elements like location 1, location 2, location 3, how it performed. So you will have a three lines and you can compare over the period, right? So I will show it once using a demo in Power BI how it looks like. And additional feature is like a secondary axis allows us to represent and visualize multiple data series without need to use additional charts. This is like you are comparing one single measure in a line chart, and you can also add another measure in the line chart to compare two different measures in the same chart. That is the one of the advantages of using a line chart. And a secondary axis to compare measure with different scales of comparison. This is another important point where your measure 1 will have a scale that is range, that range of values is from 0 to 100, and the second measure can have a range from 100 to 2000 also, right? How you can compare, right? So the values are, the scales of two different measures are very, it is very different. So you can compare using a line chart. Once we move on to Power BI demo, you can understand it better. Let's move on to Power BI. So this is the line chart. You can see here, I have used the line chart here. And let's try to build the line chart. As I said before, we need to use the dim date, right? I use the dim date is connected to Fact Internet Sales. This is the AdventureWorks DB. And so I use the dim date in the X axis. Then I will remove this day. I'm not going to drill down till day. So I'm removing it. And for, I want to compare the order quantity. So here it is. And I will remove this filter. Actually, I filtered long back. So you see there are 4 years of data, and 2013, you have a very decent data. Let us drill down to 2013 and we will see it, the data over here. Okay, now you can see here from January till October, you have data in 2013. So this is the, this way you can see the data easily in the line chart. You can see the trend, that is upward trend, where from the Jan and till April it is growing, and April to July it was stable, then again there is an increase. This is what you can easily figure it out. As I said before, you can have a different category of comparison, right? Before that, let me increase the size of this visual, I mean to say the axis, so that it will be visible to everyone, those who are viewing this video. Okay, this is fine. Now I'm coming to the point number 2 that we have discussed, like you can have more than one group of comparison. What it mean? So here you have a concept called legend, right? So the same comparison, this is overall, I want to compare along for the different territories. So I can have a territory group here. So now you can see quickly out of which the North America has performed really well compared to other territories, and you can see the trend as well, right? So this way you can easily compare. When you drill down further, there was slight changes over here for different period. In this it is light, I mean it, there was a decrease, whereas for North America it was an increase, whereas for Europe it was a decrease. So you can easily compare the results between different groups in line chart. So the another point what we have discussed about the line chart is that you have secondary axis, meaning like you can also add another measure of comparison. What it says here, you can see the quantity over here is it is the quantity is not more than 0 to 3000. That is the maximum scale, right? Let me increase the y-axis as well. So let me increase the size. So now you can see the axis value ranges from 0 to 3000. That is maximum sales quantity doesn't exceeded 3K. It is automatically fetched based on the data available. Now, when I try to add sales amount in the secondary value, what it says, it will not allow me, because as I said before, either you can use the group of values comparison here, or once you remove legend, now you can able to add the secondary axis. Now what happened, you can see here the value of the quantity ranges from 0 to 6k. It is automatically adjusted, but maximum there is no 6k and all. Okay, this blue line, light blue indicates order quantity, whereas the dark blue indicates the sales amount. You can see the scale of this sales amount ranging from 0.5 million to 2.5 million, whereas quantity is 0 to 6k. This is what the scale comparison. Okay, how you can change it? You can go here and again you can increase the size. So in this, futures are not available in other charts. When you copy and paste this chart into some bar chart kind of stuff, right, you do not have option of secondary axis and all, right? You can compare the two here. What is the difference I want to make you to understand is, like, here in the bar chart you have only one scale here, 0 to 2 million. It is whichever is highest, that is sales amount, against you measuring the sales quantity, right? So this comparison will not be useful here, because the sales quantity is very minimal compared to the sales amount. So you cannot compare in this bar charts. That is why you can go for this line charts when you want to compare two different measures having different scales, right? You can add it in the secondary axis. That is what I want to explain. And you can add the legend here, whereas in the bar chart, that is different story. But to compare two different measures having different scale, you need to go for the line chart. So this is what I want to highlight. So some of the properties to highlight here is, like, you can change this to, instead of continuous, you can change to categorical, so that it will have whatever appear in the hierarchy. And you can set the concatenate label so that it will appear like proper hierarchy, the year at the bottom and followed by a quarter, and you can see the value here. And for this you need to ensure, like, sort by year, quarter, month, okay, instead of order quantity. This should be ensured and you will have a proper value. I hope this is collapsed. That is fine. Ascending, okay, ascending, and you should specify this value. And other properties are common across other charts. That is as usual, and you can explore it always. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. And do remember that data is your asset.